Okay, hi there. What this is going to be is a quick little demonstration on how to clean your, to blow out your fuel filter system or your carburetor. A lot of people don't understand that you need to install an inline fuel filter on not just the 4-stroke engines, but every engine that you install on a bicycle. They need fuel filters, and because a lot of people don't put them in, they end up with the problem, and it ends up all being plugged up. So what I'm going to quickly do here is show you how to unplug your fuel filters or your fuel system so you no longer have a problem. So all you do is there's two tabs where I'm pointing, one here and one here. You press the tabs down, the filter cover comes off, you pull off the air filter portion. Inside is two 8mm screws. You undo the 8mm screws, or nuts I should say, bolts. Okay, so that's one. So these two, hold on a second. These two bolts, rather long bolts, hold everything together. The air filter, the carburetor, the gaskets, right to the cylinder. There we go. Okay, so now the carburetor is free. Be gentle with your gasket. I'm just going to set it here. Anyhow, this filter, or I mean this particular gasket that I'm holding right here, goes against the cylinder right here. Okay, so the reason I haven't pulled this carburetor off yet is because there is a crank vent tube, and here it is right here, and it goes into this right here. And what it is any blow by that comes from the crank from escaping compression goes into the air filter and then is re-entered into the carburetor, and then it gets burned again. Okay, so now all you do is you can see that all I have to do is pull the carburetor away from the air filter, and you can see there's the filter housing right there. Just put this aside the way it is. No need to take that apart. Okay, so the next step is we're going to remove this bolt here and expose the, and it's a 10 mil. Okay, so undo this. Alright, you can see that it has an O-ring. I don't know if you can see that. It has an O-ring on the bottom of that. Be careful not to lose it. So now, once you've got that off, the float bowl, the bowl itself comes off. There's no gasket on there to worry about, but there is an O-ring gasket between this and the carburetor itself. Okay, so now, if you can see what I'm pointing to right here, this is a little pin. And the pin is held in by the float bowl. And once the float bowl is off, you can remove this small pin. I hope you can see that. Okay, so you pull this pin out, Excuse my fingers. All right, so there's the little pin. Okay, you can see that. You pull that pin out, put it somewhere safe because you don't want to lose it. Now, you have the float bowl. And attached to the float bowl, and you can see it, it's right here. I'm pointing to it with the tip of my finger, is a little, it's a little valve. And that valve, I don't know if I can get something to point with. Let me see if I can find something to point with here. That valve fits in this, that hose in the way, in this little inlet. And that valve moves up and down and lets fuel in according to how much fuel you're using at the time. Okay? So you will now take an air fitting and with your fuel line attached as well as your fuel filter, you will now take your fuel filter, the tank filter. This cannot be used as a filter for your carburation system. Put that aside. Make sure your fuel valve is turned to the on position. A crossways is off. And in line with the fuel line is on. So now you're going to take some air and you're going to spray air in this right here, in that little thing that I showed you where the little valve goes. Spray air in there and air will come through here and it'll blow the air filter or the fuel line clean. Okay, once that's done, you've cleaned out the line, you can now put it back together. And it's really simple to put back together. The float bowl with the little valve that we've been talking about that goes inside this brass fitting. You slide that into, I hope you can see this. See if I can get it. No, not enough light. See if I can. Okay, you see that? It slides into that. Alright, so once you've got that, then you get your pin that you've taken out. See if I can give you some kind of a background. You take that pin, now you're going to slide the pin back in. Okay. So here's actually how this actually works when it's in the carburetor. Okay, so when there's fuel, I'm up too high. Okay. Let's see if I can hold this so that I can demonstrate it. Okay. So this little guy moves up and down. And it's called a float. Alright, this meters how much fuel will be in the float bowl. Alright, and it gets easily plugged. And when it does, you need to take this apart the way I just showed you and clean it out. Okay, so now you're going to turn it back over. Now you have the float bowl. Okay, there is only one way that this goes back on. There is a whole bunch of different directions you can put it. But what you're going to do is this part right here that I'm tapping at, this is actually a drain. Like if you need to drain your carburetor, if you're going to have your engine sit for a while and you want to drain the carburetor, there's a screw in here and you can unscrew this like a turn or two turns, and it will physically drain the bowl and you will no longer have any fuel in it. That's for storage. Okay, so this piece here goes to the back side of the carburetor, and you can identify the back side of the carburetor by two ways. One is, here is where where your throttle cable goes through. And the other way is